What's going on, Geminis? It's your boy Gem Mint back with another statue unboxing and review. This time we have the Prime One Studio in collaboration with Sideshow Collectibles new 52 Batman. This is a quarter scale piece. This is the exclusive Prime One style, baby, with these two humongous boxes. This one's light, probably is the cape and the body. This feels like the base. Before we get started, make sure to hit that subscribe button, make sure to like this video, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss one. We're going to jump into this unboxing right now. Alright, so now we have the art boxes. Just clean black and white look, got bat logos on it, new 52 logos on it. Definitely a Prime One production. I think Sideshow just lent them the quarter scale license to do a regular DC character as opposed to some kind of like variation like Shogun or something along those lines. But let's go ahead and get the base out first and start getting these pieces up. Yeah, so like I said, Prime One definitely produced it. So they have their 2019 calendar, because the older piece, not that old, kind of where everything is in the base, instruction booklet, etc. This one has two layers, so I'm guessing the cape's on one. All right, so you got some washers and nuts here. All right. We got this piece of the base with this broken glass look. Super heavy. It looks dangerous as hell, but it does look cool. All right, so we do have the base on the bottom here. Let's get the base on the turntable. All right, so you just have a rubble-looking base. You can see it's number 472 out of 600. This is the exclusive piece. And it does want us to get this big back part in first, so let's do that. All right, so the rest of this layer, we have three different gargoyles. You have this bigger one here, who looks like his arm is also in this layer. So, can't be a Batman without a gargoyle, right? So this has this building textured gargoyle. It looks old, it looks weathered. All right, and then like I said, you have two smaller ones. They look identical, hands close together, similar type of face. Yeah, like, I think they're the same sculpt. No wings on these ones. Here's one of the wings to the big one. There's probably gonna be a wing in the other box. And then sure enough, here is his arm giving you a thumbs up. All right, here we go. Now we got the other box with all the goodies inside. Let's take a look at them. All right, we got a right hand with a grappling gun. Kind of a smooth look on him. Different than like the Arkham pieces or even the Dark Knight Returns piece. So it's kind of smooth. Different type of gun design. Here we got a left hand. They got like a weathered look on the gauntlet here. The spikes are black as well, but you see this kind of like metal sharpened look around the edges of it. And what we're all here for is the portraits. So very white eyes, you know, new 52, so it's based off the comic book. Interesting texture on the face there. Kind of a rough look. All right, but he got a closed mouth, short ears. I'm guessing this is the exclusive, so very similar in the portrait. He's just gritting his teeth. He's grilling 12-pack on you guys. Teeth are done well, though. Shiny gums, nice shine to the teeth. I like the back of the neck, too. I hope that seam looks okay, though. All right, we got a switch out left hand, and this one looks really cool because he's got this huge piece of kryptonite in his hand, translucent resin. It looks really good. That pops. I'm definitely going to display this. And then you have a foot, but it's a good opportunity to get a close-up to see the detail. So again, very smooth-looking costume. Not really that much texture going on here. You got an interesting design around like the shin guard here. The bottom of the foot has this this shoe pattern, very muddy looking and weathered, so that's a good look. All right, now we just need to get out the cape and the body. And these huge sculpted capes are the reason why these pieces need two boxes. Nice cape though, man. Huge. And lastly, here's the body. Has a lot of weight to it. Very dense, small piece, but he's a thick one too, man. Check this guy out. We'll be right back.
All right, so that looks like all the hard parts. It's cool because it has these like little blocks that cover up the squares where you bolt the cape and the body to. So that covers up. Got his foot in there. Let's put the kryptonite hand on. Let's put his grappling hook hand on, and it has the little harpoon. And let's get the head sculpt on, make sure that we're all framed up, and we can take a look at this guy. So let's try to measure this guy. It looks like the top of his cape is his tallest point. He's about 27 and a half inches tall. His width, forget about it. It's about the same. It's really like the shape of a big square. The depth doesn't really have to be that bad. I mean, the base in itself is about 14, 15 inches, although his gun will be pointing out a little bit, but that's okay for where I want to put him. So first, let's take a look at the base. I really like how much is going on with the base. You have these three gargoyles, two small ones with a bigger one with wings in the center, and I really like how he's perched up on the edge of this little platform. He's gripping the edge of it. I think that looks great. The other two, they're not exactly the same. The magnets, you could tell which ones fit in which area. But I like how they're all huddled together, and I really like that rubble look. It's sitting on top of this kind of sub-base, this stylized bat symbol base, which I like. Going around to the back, you have this little kind of railing that you key in. That looks good. I like how it's kind of off-centered like that. And then you have this big window pane with a frame around it and bricks around it. And of course, all these shards of glass. I think that's a really nice touch. It adds a lot of depth. It doesn't have the prettiest seams where it keys in though. So that is a little nitpick. I tried to play with it for a little while. But what are you going to do? It looks like some of these glass pieces, they couldn't hurt from a Windex as well. But I like how big it is. It has a lot of presence. A lot of times you see windows or things like that on statues and they look out of scale. This one looks like it's in scale for sure. And then you have Batman. He is a long Batman too. Like from his foot, let's see, from his foot. Yeah, he's almost like 24 inches stretched out from his foot to his head. I mentioned, like, you know, the smoothness of his costume, but there's a lot of line work that they sculpted in there. We showed up close the feet and the hands, so you have that similar type of three stripes kind of gauntlets around his shins and on his wrists. He's got his patented utility belt. It's a thick, hard-looking belt. It doesn't look like pouches. It looks more like, you know, like metal slots. You see a lot of the muscles and anatomy through the costume. I like that smooth bat logo. That's the new 52 bat. And like I said, everything's smooth, but you can see right here, kind of, I guess, where your arms would move, where it has a different texture. I think it's also very difficult to get this cape into where the body connects and to where the back of the wall connects. And I can see a little gap if I'm looking at it from a lower level, which I'm gonna have it a little bit higher up. So that's a little bit noticeable. I'm sure you're supposed to probably hit it with a blow dryer or something, but I don't know, that's a big piece of cape. I think it's always difficult engineering-wise when you have multiple points of connections, right? It's hard to get all that lined up. The cape itself is super impressive though, man. The way that it swoops is big, smooth gush of a cape. I think that looks really good. It's so dynamic, the pose, the cape, everything. He's outstretched. He's ready to shoot his grappling hook and his harpoon to the next building. I think that looks cool, man. This is I think a contender for one of the best quarter scale Batman pieces. He's got a lot going on. I really do like the paint on this window frame too. I think they really did a good job of that concrete asphalt look. A very black and gray statue altogether, right? The only little hints of color is the silver base on the bottom, the mud on his boots, the goldish looking utility belt and his face, right? Everything else is literally black and gray. The cowl's got some nice sculpt details in there where his eyebrows are, where his ears are. Like his real ears, not his bat ears. I'm going to try to get him up there next to Doomsday and Superman and see how he pairs up with these guys. I like how big he is. He should hold his own with Superman. His cape's casting a shadow on me. But, yeah, man, I'm really digging this piece. I like how it looks a lot. I think it's really impressive. It stands out. It's definitely not a boring piece by any means here. All right, let's go ahead and switch out. So, very strong magnet in the arms. The arm switch out. He's holding the piece of kryptonite. And actually, that adds another layer of color because otherwise, like I said, all really grays and blacks. And then we'll take out that portrait and we'll put his gritting his teeth portrait. So now he means business. He's got kryptonite. He's angry. He's harpooning to the next area. Yeah, you got to display it with the kryptonite. I mean, I think that just looks so awesome. Yeah, and the gritting the teeth, I think that does a lot for me as well, because how do you keep a cool, calm face when you got this much going on, right? So I think that's a really good look. I want to hear what you guys think about it in the comments below. If you guys like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel by hitting that gem to the left. And if you want to see more statue unboxing and reviews, go ahead and hit the playlist to the right. Thanks for watching. Stay minty fresh. Peace.